Today we'll be talking about how to replace the fuses on an R6 Regen unit. My name is Eric Danner and I'm an elevator applications engineer here at KEB America. The R6 Regen unit, typically found in elevator and hoist applications, takes energy that is typically wasted and converts it into usable electricity that can be fed back onto the grid. A power surge or short inside the F5 or R6 may cause a fuse inside the R6 Regen unit to blow. Now, we'll get into how to replace the fuse. The R6 Regen can be wired in two different schematics. In Scheme A, the F5 drive is powered by the Regen. In Scheme B, the F5 has three-phase power going into it. If a fuse in an R6 Regen unit wired in Scheme A is blown, the drive will not turn on. If wired in Scheme B and a fuse is blown, both the Regen and the drive will power on, but the drive will have an error overvoltage fault. The first step in replacing the fuses in an R6 Regen unit is to remove the power from the unit and allow at least 5 minutes of time for the DC capacitors to discharge. What you'll need to replace an R6 fuse is a 6mm hex wrench, a Phillips screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver, the replacement fuse, and a multimeter. To replace a size 15 R6 Regen fuse, you will need a 600 volt 50 amp fuse. To replace a size 19 R6 Regen fuse, you will need a 600 volt 125 amp fuse. Remove the keypad and remove the cover found here by squeezing its sides and lifting up. Remove the X2A terminal strips found here gently with a screwdriver. The next step is to remove the three screws on the strain relief bar and the drive itself. The next step is to remove the cover as shown by gently lifting up. Please note that there are two tabs at the bottom. From here, you can see whether your fuses are blown. A blown fuse will have a tab popped out on the bottom. This fuse is bad, while this fuse, which has its tab attached, is good. Remove the control board fastening screw. Gently lift up on the control card and remove it. Be mindful of the pins at the bottom of the control card. The next step is to turn the drive upright and remove this screw. The next step is to remove the fan from the plastic housing. On the bottom of the unit, there are two tabs that hold the plastic housing on. On the top of the unit, there are an additional two tabs that hold the housing on here and here. Release the two top tabs by gently lifting up with a screwdriver on each side. Next, release the bottom. Gently lift on the plastic housing and place it on the side. The next step is to remove the two screws found here and here. Replace the blown fuse with the good fuse and refasten the screws. The next step is to replace the plastic housing, ensuring that it clicks into both the top and the bottom tabs. Replace the fan back into its slot. Reinstall the control board, being mindful not to bend its pins as you reinsert it into its slot. Press squarely down, ensuring that it makes a good contact. Reinstall the control board fastening screw. The next step is to replace the cover plate by seating it into the two slots found on the bottom of the drive. Refasten the three screws on the face of the unit. Replace the X2A terminal strips. The next step is to replace the keypad, pressing up on the lever until it clicks. The final step is to do a diode check on both the drive and the Regen unit. The first step of this is set your multimeter to diode check. Then, take the positive lead and put it in the negative terminal on the Regen unit. Then, take your negative lead and put it into the L12 terminal on the Regen. The value should read between 0.3 and 0.4. Next, take the negative lead and put it into L22. Again, the value should read between 0.3 and 0.4. And finally, L32. Next, take your negative lead and place it into the plus-plus terminal of the regen unit. Take the positive lead and put it into L12. Again, the three values measured on L22 and L32 should be between 0.3 and 0.4. If the values are all between 0.3 and 0.4, the regen diodes are good. If you have any further questions, please contact KEB America.